In the previous module, we learned about the MoveIt commander as a command line interface to talk to MoveIt by entering commands ourselves or with a script. Now, let's learn how can we do that in our own Rust node using the MoveGroup interface and create a simple pick and place pipeline. The MoveGroup interface is a collection of APIs to access the various capabilities of the MoveGroup Rust node of MoveIt. We can use these APIs to create our own Rust-based MoveIt applications. For this module, the goal is to set up a simple pick and place pipeline in code with MoveGroup APIs. Specifically, we will do this using Rust Action clients to talk to MoveIt. All right. Let's first get a conceptual overview of the MoveGroup interface, for which we will go back to this block diagram we had seen when we configured controllers for MoveIt. Now, we said MoveIt will take care of trajectory execution for us by coordinating with Gazebo or real hardware. Sure. But how do we send these trajectories to MoveIt? We do that with the MoveGroup interface. As a matter of fact, the MoveIt command line interface that we used in the previous video also implicitly used the MoveGroup interface to send trajectories to MoveIt. But hey, we also learned that we can write MoveIt commander scripts to program a sequence of commands to our robot arms and make them do what we want, which could also be a sequence for pick and place motions. So why do we need a different way to do the same thing again? Well, first, we can access more capabilities of the MoveGroup node instead of just relying on the limited set that is provided by MoveIt commander. Moreover, we can process intermediate results in our program. For example, the go named target command we saw in the last video actually does multiple things. Internally, like first setting the name target as the goal, then planning a trajectory to the goal, then time parameterizing it, and then sending the trajectory to MoveIt. But we might want to post-process the motion trajectory. For example, we want to examine the trajectory for unexpected changes in robot configuration due to the use of randomized planners. In essence, explicitly using the MoveGroup interface gives us flexibility in designing our application. Additionally, in the context of automated behavior design in robotic applications, motion module is just like one component along with many others. So, requiring the user to enter commands to get things moving will be cumbersome. Ideally, the user should be, the user input should be just the press of a button that starts the entire robotic application, and then you just sit back and relax and watch the robot do its thing. And just admire at yourself how well you programmed the robot such that it's doing exactly what you want. A practical advice here is also to just have the emergency stop nearby just in case. All right then. Let's use the APIs of MoveGroup interface to set up our own simple pick and place software pipeline as a ROS node. And for the communication with MoveIt, we will be using the execute trajectory action client. See you soon.